Yeah, no.
Добрий день, шановні колеги. Good afternoon, dear colleagues. First, I'd like to thank the organizing committee and Olena Fisenko for the good opportunity to visit Chernivtsi University of Chernivtsi and to present here at the conference the result of work of my research laboratory, my research team, at the set of posters and oral presentation. Thank you. And now, before the conference, I was going to talk about various types of polymer oxide composites, but due to a lack of time, I will know only one type of such composite. This polymer composite based on the cellulose polymer. Cellulose incorporated with some oxide compound, and cellulose based composite very perspective as they have light weight, high tensile strength and modulus, and compare low cost, especially now we see the market of such type composite based on the micro nano cellulose. That is why we prepared and studied the set of micro nano cellulose samples using so-called dry pressure procedure and prepared sample were doped with some oxides. You see the list of some papers related to the system, the book, the review, and also the work of our colleague from Poland, those studied the set of based on cellulose materials, especially luminescence materials. I no doubt you are known in cellulose, but I am not known. So some steps from tree to molecular chain, molecular structure of the cellulose from meter scales, centimeter scale, millimeter scale, and cellular structure of the tree, then cell wall structure of the tree, then fibril matrix structure and fibril structure of the cellulose, and it's interesting it contains from crystalline cellulose and some part of amorphous cellulose, and you see also the chain of cellulose on the nanometer scale. Linear cellulose chains connected by strong internal bonds is microfibril spirally together in the wall of one cell. This is a crystalline part of the cellulose, and also I say about amorphous region of the cellulose, those characterized by weaker internal bonding. Cellulose is a natural hydrophilic biopolymer that consists of glucose units and so on. So you see this chain, also the element of the space structure, and also the chemical formula of the cellulose. It's very simple formula also. But I'd like to emphasize the presence of many surface molecular groups on the cellulose microfiber. We deal with artificial cellulose, the microcrystalline cellulose. They produced by various chemical procedure. And nanoparticle of cellulose characterized as nanowhiskers, nanofibrillated cellulose, nanofibrillated cellulose, depending on their size and extraction methods. incorporation of inorganic oxide luminescence additives into microcrystalline cellulose matrix is of our special interest, especially as my group is have an extensive experience in this field of science. Sample preparation briefly. Grinding, mixturing, suspenses, then evaporation, ultrasonic treatment, so on. So finally, the measurable cellulose oxide microcomposite samples were of the disc form of average diameter near 10 millimeters, thickness near 1 millimeter, that depends on the sample composition. Luminescence active is containing European ions oxide as lanthanum vanadate, potassium phosphate molybdate, and zirconia were used as oxide component of the composite. And several sets of these samples were prepared and studied with various concentrations, with various content of oxide. Sample characterization. Property of the micronon cellulose sufficiently depend on its fabrication procedure, methods of functionalization, modification, and treatment. Therefore, maybe as samples have been widely characterized as a mechanical, thermal, thermomechanical, dielectric, and optical luminescence characteristics were measured. All of these characteristics can be useful in the future. The sample were characterized by well-known methods. Crystallinity index, dielectric permittivity, shape and size of composite component also were evaluated as they are also important for different applications. Some same images of the starting microcellulose, you see, and dispersed and then pressed micro nanocellulose samples of various scale. So we can state that we see the ceramics-like structure of the cellulose matrix after pressure, grain and various sized build of, without oxide samples. Also, the similar structure characterized cellulose oxide micro-nanocomposites. Plate of cellulose matrix and oxide particles are over there, we see. Also, we see some area where chemical element analysis is made. In this area, and surely we found that carbon and oxygen are the predominant components of the undoped sample. Similar data was found for the C3 samples where the concentration of oxide is higher, is highest. And also we see other type particles in this composite, and they show some amount of potassium, europium, and molybdenum for these samples where this oxide was used. So we see small but various size particles, of, and they are real inclusions of the oxide components. Except the data confirm these conclusions. We see here the pattern X-ray diffraction for pure cellulose and also for the composites. White line is reflect of the cellulose, and the thin fine line, this is a reflex of the oxide. Using this data, we are able to evaluate the crystallinity level of these samples, and we see that latest parameters and crystallinity levels depend on the concentration of the oxide. dilatometric behavior. We made and TGA analysis also. We see the dependence on the content of oxide. So we can conclude that this dependence are similar to those measured for another type of cellulose composite, where other these dependencies relate with characteristic of the microfibrils and molecular group on the surface of these microfibrils. As for dielectric properties, we measured the real part of dielectric permittivity, temperature dependencies we see here. For various types of the samples, with and without of the oxide. You see the influence of the oxide on these dependencies. So we conclude the dependencies of imaginary part have to complete the described data, and next slide shows this imaginary part of dielectric permittivity. The shape and dependencies value when the content of oxide change. Then we conclude that oxide particle block changes methyl group conformation, as methyl groups are the main component of the surface molecular group. And this result agrees with the data from the literature. And we see that several various mechanisms determine properties both of undoped and cellulose oxide materials, change of the sample humidity, desorption of ambient gases, kinetic of the cellulose surface groups, and phase transformation. And about luminescence. Luminescence is a complex of several luminescence bands, and this luminescence cover all the visible range of the spectrum, and this luminescence is typical for publish it and discuss it about cellulose spectra. They depend on the excitation wavelengths and on the pretreatment of this sample. If we regard the luminescence of the site as a composition of luminescence of cellulose matrix and the luminescence of oxide, so the white photoluminescent spectrum of cellulose, when combined with intensive red emission of oxide, is suitable for creation and downshifting converting lanes for violet LED and then formation of white light emitting diode. Here you see the spectrum of this luminescence, also the model of some device, the radiation of the blue LED without color, and down the radiation of the system blue LED plus cellulose plus oxide, and we see that this emission is white on eye. And so conclusion about this result, and also about perspective of these materials in the future. And some thanks, acknowledgement of my partner, from my research team, from various universities. Some of them are here at the conference. It's Oksana Chukova, Vladimir Boyko, Vasily Shcherbatsky, Irina Nedelko. This conference, thanks. And thanks for financial support. Thanks for your attention. Okay. We obtain it from the optical microscopy and from scanning electron microscopy and from atomic force microscopy that in the macro scale the samples are non-heterogenic, heterogenic, they are not uniform. But if we regard the small area near 2 micrometer, we can find the area with good homogeneity. If we speak about size of the oxide particles, then the size of oxide particles determined by the method of their preparation. Oxide particles prepared before the composition. Before. So the size were from 10 to 100 nanometers. It just depends on the method of oxide preparation, also from the compound.
What is
the real size of the oxide particles in this composite? If we see the electron microscopy images, are in the range from 10 nanometer to 1-200 nanometers.
No.
As I said, these samples are not homogeneous. So we see that many area in the size of 1-5 micrometer, where only small particles are of the size 10 to 20 nanometers. And also we see the large agglomerate of this particles also.
And those are
which
size?
Yeah.
What is the size of
those? Up to 1 micron.
Okay.
Thank you.
Very much.
Thank you.